So when we first got here, there was a guy in there who came out and he had a dog. The dog came into our car. I thought I was about to mace a dog right in the face, but he seemed kind of nice, but I wasn't confident enough to open the door. But this guy approached me, he's missing all his front teeth. He's like, hey, I'm friendly. Plucker, you know, and just tell me some Vermont or something. He's wearing an Issaquah lacrosse hoodie. Like, where the hey, my brother played for Issaquah lacrosse, you know? And, okay, so I'm rambling. But yeah, so there's a guy, he was sleeping in there. And meeting Kyle and I yesterday, we were out here shooting, and this truck was here. What the owner of this? Because the windows are all rolled down. He was in there the whole time. The only reason why I didn't know he's in there the whole time is because he has plywood all in the back windows, and he has like a little hut, and like it's not even connected to the truck, so you can't even know what the fuck. It's like a little house. It's, like, it's all boarded up, a mystery box, like a heroin addict. This hypodermic needles we found in between our fire pit over there to the left. The truck right there is like right by where we found the hypodermic needles. Okay, so when I asked him, I was like, hey, we saw your truck out here all day yesterday. Where were you? And he's, I was just in there sleeping. You can hear the gunshots. We're just only like 20
he's
yards
a sound
away,
sleeper.
No, man, I was just sleeping.
Bullshit.
The hypodermic needles pretty much explain it. You know? That's why he didn't hear the gunshots right next to his house. You know, like, what the fuck?
Sketchy, right, anyway, sketch.
We just got a Sidney Crosby target up, so let's get to that. After we make sure it's safe.
And not get like
not awake with his dog and shit. This flashlight may look like nothing, but extremely bright. If a drug addict, homeless person attacks you, you just go
strobe.
You just go, hey, wait, watch out. Oh shit, where am I? You know, there's a serrated edge right here, and you know how people commonly break their hand when they get in street fights? Well, this right here is just a hand support for your fist, and serrated edge for hammer fisting while you're stroke out of the drug. So
that's the best technique.
This is actually good. If you're at a bar, if you're against any inebriated person, this thing just works just like a charm, dude. Whether or not you're trying to fuck him up or trying to fuck you up or just trying to distract him and get the fuck out of it. Whichever way works, you know?
Survival tips.
Yeah, so. Either if you think it wasn't the color orange, you know? Like one of them, the plunger, I was like, what is that? Oh, epidermic needle, what the?
Hey, don't be stepping on that shit.
I'm just gonna get this log.
Oh. You fucked the thing up. Oh, yep.
Bear mace. Bear mace stun gun.
Yo, watch out for that needle. Don't step on this shit.
Dude, I'm just like.
Yes. Man wins. Yep.